Welcome back. In our last video, we set up some text to display to the screen when the game was playing, the player had won, or the game was over. There's a couple other things we want to have happen for our different playing states, though. So we have all states have the HUD text, that's already ready and set up for us. But we do want to have some things happen with the spawn volumes, so when you're playing the game, the spawn volumes are spawning pickups. When you win the game, the spawn volumes stop spawning pickups, and when the game is over, the spawn volumes also stop spawning pickups, but at that point also the character collapses and the player is not able to input anymore. So in this video we're going to get started with working with the spawn volume class so that we can have that work with our new play states. This will include adding a new function to the spawn volume class and also registering all the spawn volumes in the level with the game mode. So first let's go to our spawn volume header file. We're going to create a new function to toggle spawning on and off. It's going to be a public function because we want other classes like the game mode to be able to reach in and access this function. And it's going to be a void function called setSpawningActive. And it's going to take a boolean for whether or not the spawning volume should spawn. We're going to make this blueprint callable so that if at some point we wanted to, in our blueprint, call whether or not the spawn volume should spawn, we can totally do that. So blueprint callable. And we'll put this in the spawning category like most of the other functions that are on this class. And of course, just our little note to self when we come back to say that this function toggles whether or not the spawn volume spawns pickups. Now we'll quickly set up the function body for this, which is in the spawn volume source file. We'll put it right here, actually right above our spawn pickup, and it will be, we'll take that same signature, a spawn volume set spawning active. And if you remember earlier, we set up a timer in begin play that would start setting a timer for whether or not our spawn pickup function should be called. We're actually going to use that same code here in our set spawning active. And this is going to toggle based on that boolean if B should spawn. So if B should spawn, then set the timer on spawn pickup. Otherwise, if B should spawn is false, then we're going to clear the timer. And that just means that the spawn pickup function wouldn't be called on a regular interval anymore. So we're going to use the world timer manager, and we'll go take this line here from begin play, and actually we're going to remove it from begin play because we only want the spawn volume to start spawning after this set spawning active function has been called. So we're actually going to cut this bit of functionality out of begin play, so completely remove it, and we're going to move it down here to inside B should spawn. So now our function reads in set spawning active, if B should spawn, so if we've given this true, then set a timer based on that random spawn delay range that we found before. And then here, if we set B should spawn to false, then we're going to clear the timer, and that's just again using world timer manager, the world. And clear timer, and we give it that timer handle of spawn timer again. So again, we're no longer on begin play setting that initial timer because we don't want the spawn volume to start spawning until we call set spawning active, and we're only going to do that from the game mode. On begin play, if we just started right now, our spawn volumes actually wouldn't spawn, and I can actually go compile that and show you. So let's open up the editor real quick, compile that code. The other thing we're going to do is register all the spawn volumes in the level. If you notice here, I've got two, but I could place three or four, and they'd all just keep spawning pickups as long as I set their what to spawn variable. And we want them all to be sort of tracked by the game mode so that as gameplay goes on, they can be turned on and off depending on whether or not the player has won or lost the game. So that's just going to keep compiling, and then we can show that I've removed that begin play initial activation of the spawn volumes. Okay, so our compile was successful, and if I hit play now, you'll notice that our spawn volumes are not spawning either our regular pickup or our battery pickup, because I've never called that set spawning active true function yet, and I removed the code from begin play. So now let's go start tracking all the spawn volumes in our level in the game mode. We'll switch back to Visual Studio and open our game mode header file, because we're going to store all of these in an array. So let's make a tArray, and this is going to be private. We're really only handling it on the code side. We don't need to access it from any other classes or any blueprints. So it's not even going to get sort of the standard U property markup. And we're going to call this array spawn volume actors. And if you haven't worked with tArrays very much before, definitely go check out the tArray documentation, which we'll link in the description for this video. And just a slightly different set of array setup than you may be used to in traditional C++. So now that we've got that spawn volume actors, we can go to the source file and collect all of those actors in begin play. So it's basically as soon as you start the game mode will go through and keep track of all of the actors, all of the spawn volume actors that it may need to communicate with later in the game. So we're just going to add a block here after we've set our HUD to find all spawn volume actors. And actually, at this point, we need to go ahead and include spawn volumes because we're going to be needing to interact with them directly and start casting things like that. So include spawn volume.h. So here's our big list of includes. Now I can go back to begin play and start writing the code to find all the spawn volume actors. We're going to use another gameplay statics function and another array to take all initial actors. So first we're going to start with that array of all actors, or the basic actor type, and we're going to call that found actors. And we're going to use that gameplay statics function, get all actors of class. And this will go through your entire level, and so if you had a very large level, you'd want to keep an eye on performance and things like that. But this is a small sort of demonstration level, and it needs to be a spawn volume. You supply what type of class you'd like to look for. And you do it here using that static class. That's just the argument that the get all actors of class function takes. And then you store that in that found actors array that we just set up. So we've set up this array of all actors, and that's just because this getAllActors of class returns the base actor type, and then we're going to work through and cast them. So as we go through all of the actors, and because of all the actors and found actors, we're going to try to cast them to spawn volumes. And if they are spawn volume, then we're going to obviously store them in that array. So again, this is your typical cast. You should be used to this at this point in the series. And I'm just going to cast a, and this is the part that meant that we had to go include a spawn volume.h in this file. And then if that cast is successful, if we've found a spawn volume actor, and again, you could actually probably do this in a more combined format, but just of keeping things sort of, this line does the cast, this line does the conditional. That's why we're separating it out a little bit for this video. And so now we're getting our hands a little set off on the keyboard. All right, spawn volume actors and add unique. And that's just so we don't end up with any duplicated spawn volume actors and any overhead from that. So now, as soon as the game begins, we're going to find all spawn volume actors using get all actors of class, casting the actors in that array that we stored the found actors in. And then if it's for sure a spawn volume, then we're storing it in our spawn volume actors array. In the next video, we'll work on actually interacting with these spawn volumes, both to enable and disable them, and also do a little bit of that final play state setup. Thanks!